हेलो एंड वेलकम टू द वीडियो लेक्चर ऑन फीचर्स ऑफ 8085 माइक्रोप्रोसेसर। दिस क्वेश्चन इज अगेन इम्पॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन फ्रॉम एग्जाम पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू वेयर यू हैव टू लिस्ट सम 5 to 6 फीचर्स ऑफ 8085 माइक्रोप्रोसेसर। सो दिस इज अ ब्लॉक डायग्राम ऑफ इंटेल्स 8085 वेयर आई हैव शोन ओनली सम इम्पॉर्टेंट सिग्नल्स लाइक एड्रेस बस 80 टू A15, डेटा बस D0 टू D7, सीरियल डेटा इन आउट, IO, M bar, the power supply and the ground pin, the crystal for generation of the frequency and the control bus. Now we'll understand the features of this 8085 in detail one by one. The first feature is it is an 8-bit microprocessor. So the meaning of 8-bit is it can process the 8-bit of data simultaneously. So here 8-bit data bus width is available, which indicate that 1 byte, that means 8 bit of data can be passed on to this bus. Now this IC 8085 is available in the 40 pin plastic ceramic DIP package. The DIP means it is a dual in line package, that means it contains two rows of pins and the total number of pins are 40 for this chip. That's why the package is called as a DIP 40 package. Then if you see the address bus, then the address bus is a 16-bit address bus, that is A0 to A15, and therefore it can address the physical memory range of 2^16 is equal to 64 kilobytes. But if you see the diagram, the address bus is divided into two different groups. The low order address bus, that is A0 to A7, is multiplexed with the data bus D0 to D7. So here the pins are named as AD0 to AD7. That means the address bus A0 to A7 and data bus D0 to D7, they are multiplexed together. So multiplexed together, the meaning is that the least significant 8 bits of address bus are transferred on the same 8 lines of data bus. And this multiplexing is actually done, or it will give you the advantage of reduction of number of pins from 16 to 8. Otherwise, there should be a separate 8 pins must be available for address, that is A0 to A7, and separate for data. So to avoid that, these low order address bus is multiplexed with the data bus. And the high order address bus is A8 to A15, which is a separate bus. Now to select the external memory or I/O devices, 8085 uses the I/O mapped I/O system or IO, M bar system. Then the important thing is the power supply. For running this chip properly, you need a power supply. The power supply required is of +5 volts, and the crystal frequency of 3 megahertz is required, which is a single phase clock. Also, the control bus is available here for transferring the different control signals from a microprocessor to the other devices. So these are all the important features of 8085 microprocessor. Here I have listed all the features in detail, so you can go through these slides. And if you are new to the channel, then don't forget to subscribe, like and share. Thank you guys. Thank you so much.